We've complained to the police about the police and nothing's been done. We've complained to magistrates about magistrates and nothing's been done. We've complained to judges about judges and nothing's been done. Now it's time to do something ourselves. That statement was made at the Mangrove demonstration and represents the essence of black people's experience in Britain. That since we've come here, we've suffered a long train of abuses by the police with the active knowledge and support of the British state. And those abuses have been able to be carried out under the pretext that, quote, black people are criminals, sponsors, and prostitutes. That is a myth that has been created about us. That is a statement that was made by one police officer who gave evidence in the Mangrove case. Now, the demonstration that black people made against the harassment of the Mangrove restaurant, the subsequent resistance in the courts, is an active explosion of that myth.
Blood, 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 blood and fire. Blood, blood, blood and fire.
Oh, mercy, Lord.
There is no more water to out the fire. There is no more water to out the fire. Let it burn.
Black community, not only in Notting Hill, but all over this country, has a certain experience with the police. And that experience, in my terms, is one which could be easily described as brutal, harassing, and generally repressive. And that on the 9th of August 1970, the Action Committee in Defense of the Mangrove Restaurant, which is a West London restaurant in Notting Hill, called a demonstration because that restaurant had been consistently harassed by the police. There were 3 raids on the restaurant, ostensibly for drugs. Nothing was found. And so the community responded with a demonstration.
It has been for some time now that black people have been caught up in complaining to police about police.
Yeah.
Complaining to magistrates about magistrates. Complaining to judges about judges. Complaining to politicians about politicians. We have become the own shapers of our destiny as from today. The precedents have been set. Young kids have committed the greatest revolutionary action that has been known in this country for some time. They walked into a police station and took it over, but the objective must be clear. The objective was to free their brothers. What our objective is today, what is going to continue to be, is a concerted, determined attempt to prevent any infringement on our rights.
What they seek to do is not to close down a restaurant, but to close down what they see is an area where black people can collectively put up some kind of resistance to day-to-day harassment by the police. And I believe the Mangrove is not just negative in serving as a place where people can put up that kind of resistance, but I believe it serves a positive purpose in that people come there and sit and talk and exchange views in the community, which this community has lacked for a long time.
The object of the demonstration was to visit every single police station in the area. We went to Nottingdale Police Station. When we got there, there were more policemen surrounding the police station. We went to Notting Hill Police Station, by which time it had accumulated in the minds of the policemen who were on that demonstration that we had taken that issue too far. They believed, what are these cheeky West Indian niggers doing on the street challenging our authority with such confidence? They sought to break the demonstration up on Portnell Road. You had Commander Gerard, you had Commander Maggs on the spot, you had numbers of inspectors, numbers of chief superintendents, and a whole host of constables lined in military formation. That is what we were presented with.
Let's go!
25 years of frustration exploded. In that explosion was Jonathan Jackson, what was taking place in Trinidad, the burning of the buses in Jamaica, the struggle of black people all over the world exploded on Portland Road.
That why that attack was launched and why subsequent to that attack by the police being launched, this thing was blown out of all proportion, was that the government had certain things in mind for black people in relation to the population as a whole. They wanted to justify the immigration bill. They wanted to justify saying that black people had to register with the police, that black people had to ask permission to have certain jobs and to move from place to place. They wanted to justify these kinds of measures. Where have you heard anywhere of a demonstration in a community of about 150 people hitting the Manchester Guardian, the Yorkshire Post? That thing is projected to the population for a particular reason.
In fact, there was evidence in the trial that the CID, Special Branch, and police photographers were on the march right from the beginning. Photographs taken before and during the demonstration were used by the police for making arrests 9 weeks later. Rothwell Kentish, riot, a fray, offensive weapon. Roden Gordon, riot, a fray. Radford Darcus Howe, riot, a fray. Godfrey Millet, riot, a fray. Frank Crichlow, riot, a fray, offensive weapon. Barbara Beese, riot, a fray, actual bodily harm of policemen, offensive weapon. Anthony Carlisle Innes, riot, a fray, grievous bodily harm of policemen, actual bodily harm of policemen, offensive weapon. Glasgow Boyce, riot, a fray, grievous bodily harm of policemen, actual bodily harm of policemen, offensive weapon. Alethea Jones LeQuant, riot, a fray. Three separate charges of actual bodily harm of policemen, offensive weapon. The Mangrove Nine, two women, seven men, 31 charges.
There had been demonstrations in Britain before that provoked much more fierce fighting than that one. There were demonstrations in Britain before in which police horses were killed and policemen were maimed. Those charges never followed those demonstrations.
Some of us were arrested about the 14th of October, which is about 9 or 10 weeks after the demonstration, and taken to Marylebone Court, charged with riot and affray. And the magistrate there threw out the charge of riot after the DPP had made very strong case to support the case of riot. Anyway, that was thrown out. We then went to the Old Bailey.
They lined us up in the dock, prisoner style, and the charge of riot was reintroduced.
The charge of riot was reintroduced by the Director of Public Prosecutions. Such a reversal of a magistrate's decision in a high court can be done by the prosecution without rhyme or reason.
Judgment has come and mercy has gone. All we caught shall leak out and speak up. Judgment has come and mercy has gone.
The Mangrove Nine trial was to be one of the longest in British legal history. It lasted 10 weeks, during which the black community showed its constant solidarity. The nine defendants took an unprecedented step. Seven were represented by legal counsel, and it was decided among them that two would defend themselves. This gave the nine vital freedom of political maneuver in the court. With their hard-earned experience of the 10 weeks of the trial, the Mangrove Nine analyzed the meaning of the ordeal they had just passed through.
See, in this particular case, the judge came with his orders from his masters, which is, this case is about a real situation involving people who are prepared to come to say what that situation is. His responsibility is to camouflage the whole situation, because his masters know what the situation is, the black population on the other hand no one want to represent, and he is supposed now to take charge of this situation so that all these things wouldn't get through. And every single lawyer but two of them know what they have to do in order to assist him to do that. They want to defend you, yes, but in defending you, they will also have to assist the judge. Is an agreement that they have.
They want to defend you as an individual, yeah.
which is assisting the judge to camouflage the entire situation of police brutality in this country.
It seems clearly to have been an attempt by the state to prevent the growth of organized resistance within the black community, which had an independent leadership. And that seems to me to have been the real point of the case. And it follows a whole series of other attempts, whenever black people have attempted to organize independently, to smash that organization before it got really solid, firm roots within the community.